This video is going to be about square roots and radicals. And since it's a pretty big topic, I'm going to do this in a series of videos. So let's get started with this. Here I have the equation 3 squared equals 9. And you know that what this means is that 3 multiplied by itself equals 9. Okay, now, I want you to compare that with this. Here I have something called a radical sign. That's this thing here. And underneath the radical sign, I have a 9. And we read this expression as the square root of 9. What that means is the square root of 9 is going to be the same as the number that I can square or multiply by itself to make a 9. So since I know that 3 squared equals 9, I can say that the square root of 9 equals 3. Okay, let's look at another one. Here I have the square root of 25. So I'm looking for the number that I can square to get whatever is under the radical sign, or the 25. Well, I know that I can square a 5. 5 squared is 25. So the solution to this is going to be 5. Now, if you think about it, you might ask, well, why isn't it negative 5? After all, negative 5 squared also equals 25. Well, the reason is this. Mathematicians have agreed that when they use this radical sign as a square root sign, they're going to only want the answer. They're only going to want the square root, which is a positive number. So even though negative 5 squared equals 25, the square root of 25 is only 5. There's no other answer to this. If you wanted to get a negative answer, you would do something like this. You would write negative square root of 4. And then you would solve that by first looking at what's under the radical sign and finding the square root of 4. Well, that's 2. And then you would take that 2 and put the negative sign in front of it. Okay? Let's look at a few more numbers just so you can see whether there's anything special or not about some of them. So for instance, the square root of 1. Okay, well, the square root of 1, I'm looking for the number I can square to make a 1. It's 1. The square root of 0. Well, since 0 times 0 is 0, the square root of 0 is 0. Here's a tricky one. I've got the square root of negative 9. Okay, well, I know that 3 times 3, or 3 squared, is 9, but I want a negative 9. And negative 3 times negative 3 is also positive 9. So there's really no way that I can solve this. This is going to have no solution. So in other words, anytime you have a square root of a negative number, you're not going to have an answer. It's going to be no solution. Okay, let's look at some problems where we have to simplify expressions containing radical signs. Okay, so we're starting with 3 times the square root of 25. The main thing to remember is that until you've gotten rid of the radical sign, you can't do anything with this 3. So in other words, first, I have to find the square root of 25. So the square root of 25 is 5, and it's going to be 3 times whatever is under the radical sign, whatever the square root of 25 is, which is 5. So this is 3 times 5, and 3 times 5, I can then multiply it, is going to give me 15. Okay, here we have the square root of 16 over 2. And we have the same thing about, well, I guess, what you might call an order of operations. We can't divide by 2 until we get rid of the radical sign. So the square root of 16, the number that I multiply by itself, or the number I square to get a 16, is a 4. And then I can put that over 2. And then I can simplify this. I can divide both the numerator and the denominator by 2. And that would just give me 2. One more. I've got the square root of 49 minus 1 over 2. And I've got to deal with this radical sign first. So the square root of 49 is the number I square to make a 49. And of course, that's a 7. So this is going to turn into 7 minus 1 over 2. I'll simplify this numerator before I do my division. So 7 minus 2 is just 6. That gives me 6 over 2. And 6 divided by 2 is going to be a 3. Okay, so that's it for this video. I'll come back and do some more to show you more details about how to deal with roots and radicals. Okay, see you soon.